Parliament will start regional sittings around the end of August, and the first is to take place in Gulu, northern Uganda. Mbarara in western Uganda will follow. Mbale in eastern will be next. The opposition members of Parliament say they have not been involved in the planning of the sittings. The leader of opposition, Joel Ssenyonyi, says the Parliamentary Commission and Business Committee, too, have not been involved. He claims that sources told him that 5 billion Ugandan shillings will be spent on each sitting and transporting MPs and parliament staff and paying their per diem.
If you were to ask the ordinary person in Gulu that this 5 billion shillings, which is going to bring MPs and staff, what would you want it to do? Maybe they will be more interested in medicine in Gulu Regional Referral Hospital. They might be more interested in infrastructure being worked on. The same situation for Mbarara, for Mbale, and so on and so forth, as opposed to spending all of this money to transport everybody empty.
There is no additional cost that is going to be incurred because of the sitting in northern Uganda. What is being done is within what Parliament had planned for in the financial year.
Ssenyonyi says although the sittings will be in the people, they will not have chance to participate since they are required to sit in the gallery. He advises the leadership of Parliament to empower committees.
And these committees go out and work on behalf of Parliament. Why don't we empower committees? Many times committees complain they are not able to go out to the field, because that should be the work of committees, that now go to this area, interact with the people, establish the issues and concerns, bring a report to Parliament. Here we discuss it all together. Why don't we empower committees? And that's what I have always been telling the leadership of Parliament.
Members of the shadow cabinet say they will not be part of the arrangement, which does not make logical and economic sense.
So as shadow cabinet, we have elected that it is problematic for we in the opposition to be part of such an arrangement, because number one, we have not been brought on board. We are kept in the dark. Things are being done very quietly. We do not know. And then number two, this expenditure is difficult for us to explain to the public, to even the people we represent, to tell them.
Stand for members to say, because of Gulu, they are going to boycott allowances. That is not the way to go as the leaders. I would personally request them to always go slow when talking about matters of their own emoluments and remuneration in Parliament.
Ssenyonyi says he has written to the Speaker of Parliament several times about commission meetings where he has not participated since the year started.
Sat in a meeting that made this decision, I would say, look, instead of spending 5 billion shillings per sitting, let's meet here. And then we push for the allocation of money for some of the concerns in these regions. That would have been my view. But I'm not invited for these meetings. And as I have since discovered, I'm not the only one not invited to these meetings. The other day we had an engagement and the Prime Minister was also concerned.
The opposition say the 11th Parliament is being run as a small institution in an informal way, which they will not sit and watch. I'm Nafka Farida and Gloria Ogwitabinji at Parliament.